Hey, Horse people. A lot of people want me to cover these fires out here. I mean, I don't know what you can say about it. You know, the horse racing industry has always been about money. They don't care about horses. You know, if there wasn't horse racing, none of these horses would have been killed or burned up. So, you know, everyone wants to make the media's making this out to be, oh, the poor workers, and oh, we couldn't save all the horses, and oh, it was so bad, and we're raising money to rebuild. You know what? I mean, one place 49 horses lost their lives, another place 29. If you can't take care of your horse, but you can get out, then you're a coward. I mean, I just don't know how else to say it. You cage a horse up, leave him locked up to burn to death, and then you want to cry about how much money it's costing you. Another big problem with fires is the smoke. I mean, horses' lungs are huge, and they have big nostrils. And if you're needing a mask, you know, your horse is sucking in a lot of soot and smoke. So, I mean, it's just sad that it's not like these fires popped up. They're blaming the fires on homeless encampments. Of course, you know, our politics now, we want to bring in every illegal. We want to open the borders. We want to bring in all these refugees. We got no place for them to stay. They don't have jobs. They can't speak English. And they run around and be homeless and want the government to protect them. They raise taxes. And then when they start fires and they do all kind of destructive, they're crapping on people's front porches and sleeping in the streets. So then all of a sudden, you know, the liberals out there are saying, oh, we just need more money. If we had more money, we could fix it. Yeah, that's always the great thing. Meanwhile, they're destroying everything, and now they're starting this fire. And of course, you know, nobody wants to talk about that. I haven't seen, I don't know if there's a lot of footage of dead horses. I mean, I'm not really searching that much, but, you know, these horses with no halters have a better chance of living than these horses with halters. But Rick, you got to be able to catch. Look, halters on horses are bad. They're going to get caught or caught on a tree. They'll get trapped. They'll run through a T-bar. I mean, there's just so many things. Take the freaking halter off and let the horses free. If you want to be a coward and run and save yourself, at least give the horses a fighting chance. Here's some footage of some of the chaos.
To 1,000 horses in a facility becomes close to impossible.
There you go.
San Luis Rey training facility moments after fire, fueled by intense winds, spread to 8 barns.
It hit the palm trees first, so it was a high, you know, it was high in the trees, and then they started falling on the barns, and yeah, I mean, it's just devastating.
Linda has been in the business 45 years. She and everyone we talked to says this is the worst disaster ever to hit the racing world.
We've always been taught as horsemen that when you lead a horse out of a burning barn, you have to put them somewhere because they will run back. That's their home. That's all they know.
You know, that's the problem with horse racing, is they're stuck in barns and that's all they know. That's just one of the many problems. Humans create the problem and then they act like the victim because the horses run back in and we can't help them because horses are just stupid and they'll run back in a burning barn. Ah, oh, the ignorance of people in the horse world.
Looking for safety, and safety is their saw.
In San Diego, hundreds of animals made it out, but some then died or were injured by smoke inhalation. Nearly 1,000 horses are stabled at Laurel.
We feel good in this barn. This is the sprinkler system, and you know, I think it's pretty well equipped.
But well, I'm glad you feel good in a barn. You know, 50 horses died, but I'm glad that you feel good in a barn.
But still, the Lilac Fire has everyone talking evacuation plans to save not just animals, but people. 288 people live at Laurel full time. In San Diego, the workers' quarters are gone.
Oh, the poor worker quarters. They lost their home. Oh, the poor horses that died. That's all right. They were insured. We'll make money on it. We'll get the insurance company to pay, and we'll buy another 1,000 horses and breed them and keep them in stalls and lock them in barns. I can't even. The horse racing industry and people in general in the horse world just drive me nuts sometimes. People wanted me to cover it. That's about all I can do. I don't want to deal with it. I'm so disgusted with it.